But she's the person who is to call them home. More than me, she is the other person. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do.
Blessings are very important. I would say that you require some sort of a catalyst to move ahead at every point of time. So also these people were sort of catalyst to you in some form or the other. Probably not in a big way, but small ways which grew up and you are what you
are. I suppose everybody heals.
Yeah.
I suppose everybody heals, but people don't realize it.
That's true.
Most of them don't realize it.
Yeah.
It is good to be aware.
Yeah, that's good.
It is not by realizing that you are going to do something different.
Right.
But it is nice to be aware, it is nice to be humble.
Right. Say it is destiny, or we might say whatever it is, but we are basically tapestry of all these people and experiences together, as you said, and beautifully put it. And I would say also say that, as you said, we might pick up some things from somebody we don't know. I would like to use that. I've used that, in fact, the analogy that there is an idol, a god we Hindus believe in, is Datta Maharaj, and he is said to have had so many gurus, and the gurus are even the ants and the other creatures, which we will say, are, what is this? This can be gurus, but they are gurus to him. That is what he has put it. So also, as you said, and it's very nice that you have given credence to all these people who have been part of your, I would say, destiny or wherever you are at this point of time. So let me cut there and move to Mumbai now, then Bombay. Yeah. How was your transition there, being there and knowing these people, getting to work with them? It was easy, it was difficult. How was it? How was the first icebreaker?
See, what happened was,
I'll just take a little bit of more time. And you did not work with a typical filmmaker. You worked with real serious filmmakers. I don't know whether there's a difference in that. But as we say, more serious filmmakers or arty filmmakers or people who understood the craft rather than just, dance and music. Go ahead. Sorry.
See, what happens is when you travel from point A to point whatever, travel starts, you have different impressions of different things at different times. Okay. Of course, I was influenced by Shyam Benegal's films. Okay. But then that is how I started seeing Satyajit Ray. Because Satyajit Ray, Shyam was influenced by Satyajit Ray and New Wave Cinema. Okay. Now I saw films like Garam Hawa, which are prior to Shyam's coming into films. But there were also other films which I had seen and I had seemingly liked them. Like I told you, Kagaz Ke Surat Guldas films, I used to like them. Okay. They were sort of partially commercial and also very artistic. Okay. I used to like Bimal Roy's films also. Because they too were very deep into the subject. If you see Sujata or if you see other films, Usne Kaha Tha or whatever, Parak. They are all socially relevant films. Even Vishantaram's films are very socially relevant. But at the same time, they were in a way commercial. And I was... At that point in time, when I to pick up from where you asked me how I came here, there was a little unfortunate incident which happened. My father was paralyzed for many years because of arthritis, was bedridden. Mm-hmm. So there were many people, doctors came in, this guy came in, that guy came in. So there was one gentleman called Mr. Vasudev Pai, who was, as you said, a Dasta Bhakta. Mm-hmm. Okay. So he came and he started treating my father. And while he was treating, he also tried to teach me how to go about it, how to imbibe that.
Okay.
Okay. And how to treat people. So I also was treating people for some time.
Okay.
With him. Okay. So that was also happening. My trips to Pondicherry also were happening, which was, I was reading Aurobindo, I was reading रमण महर्षी हे सगळे वाचनही चाललंय. ऍट द सेम टाइम आय वॉज रिडिंग जी ए कुलकर्णी, पु ल देशपांडे, एव्हरीथिंग, ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर हॅपनिंग. ओके, ऍट द सेम टाइम आय वॉज रिडिंग रशियन लिटरेचर, ऍट द सेम टाइम आय वॉज रिडिंग इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर हॅपनिंग. पोएट्री, म्युझिक वॉज हॅपनिंग एज यू नो, यूज टू कम अप, कम अप देअर. सो आय स्टार्टेड तबला विथ प्रभाकर सर, प्रभाकरचारी.
I just break you here. It's so very surprising that there's a lot of coincidence and a similarity. In fact, you studied in the same school that I studied in, People's High School, which was one of the best at that point of time. Even today, it is good, of course. Then we studied in the same college. We worked in the same newspaper, Navin Times. And I had my first guru, tabla guru, is Mr. Chari. Chari Guruji. Second one. Because Chari sir, Chari Guruji just stopped or something like that. I shifted to Bugde Guruji, which was at your place.
And I shifted for the same reason.
Okay.
So that was also happening. All these things were happening. My father was unwell. So this gentleman, Mr. Vasudev Pai, was from Malad, Bombay. Okay. So he came and he started treating. He used to treat at Bhatkar's house. चपलांचे ढीक पडले असेल दादा. सो ही स्टार्टेड टीचिंग मी ऑल्सो, आय स्टार्टेड असिस्टिंग हिम. तू काय शिकत आपण बारीक बारीक पेशंट आहे ते तू घे.
बेसिकली स्पिरिच्युअल,
इट वॉज स्पिरिच्युअल.
ही सॉ सम स्पार्किंग, आय वुड से.
करेक्ट. सो ही डिड, यस. अँड ही इनिशिएटेड मी टू इन टू दिस थिंग. सो असं जाता जाता देन डू मेडिटेशन करत चाललो. देन देयर वॉज अ गर्ल नेम शारदा, शी केम टू आवर हाऊस वन डे अँड वी डिड नो हर. ओके, अँड ही गॉट हर, शी इज नॉट वेल. So we are treating her. So can she, I would want her to stay here. Okay, then tanto hakkat itla ashillo ki he would not ask, he would take you.
Yeah.
Okay. So and my father was more than welcome. He said, yeah. That's it. He called and he came. Then he told some math, achi information dile. Okay. She was in our house. Okay. And after 2-3 days, she was seriously ill. Okay. Then my father knew her brother. Satyananda Shirodkar. So he called him in Bombay. Satyananda was in Bombay. So Satyananda rushed back. By the time she was okay.
Okay.
By the time he came, next day she was all right. That particular evening she was completely down.
Got it.
So next day she was all right by the time treatment in Tabla Dajar. So she was okay. And Satyananda was very thankful. He said, I don't even know you. You don't even know me. And you just allowed this. My father said, here it is always like that.
Right.
Okay, so that's how we and Ratna and Ratna started talking. He said, what do you do? He says, yeah, I'm a painter. He said, you're a painter. Mm-hmm. So I said, yeah, but when you commercially pay a painting, I'm a painting. Okay, what do you want to do further? I said, yeah, I want to be a cinematographer. I want to do cinema. Said, you're a painter. I said, yeah, I want to do cinematography. Okay. He said, then, because he was a director of Chaitra advertising.
Uh-huh.
Which we didn't know. So, okay, I'll go to Mape and I have a friend and I'll speak to him. And if you want to, then you come there. I will send you a letter or I'll call you up and then you come immediately. But at first, I'll speak to my friend. So I said, okay, fine. And he went, and after that 1 month, there was no. So many people promised.
That's true.
So, okay, I had forgotten about it. But one day I did get a call from him. But he said, immediately come. I have spoken to a person called Nandu Ghanekar, who has an ad film agency. Mm-hmm. And I think you should start there. So I said, okay, any start was a good start. So I rushed to Bombay. Amchi bus ashilli. Bus here baslo. Chalo Bombay. Yeah. Follow Bombay. And along with me, Baiju also came.
Okay.
Baiju also was looking out for a space in Bombay. Mm-hmm. So along with me, Baiju also was there. And both of us landed in Bombay. He started staying somewhere in Chandanwadi. I was staying in Grand Road with my aunt. So, the this. So, okay, from the next day, on the same day rather, I went to Dadar to meet Nandu. Datta was there. So, no, Datta came. Datta took me to Nandu, introduced me to Nandu. My mom was also there with me. And Nandu, Vaishali, all these people in their house and Dadar, opposite Swaminarayan. So, Pam Guru, his mother was there. And he talked to me and he said, let's see you. He said, I told him, I want to be a cinematographer. He said, who you want to work with? He said, no, I want to work with Govind Nalani. So, his junoon had influenced me. Uh-huh. So, he said, okay, you can't work like that. No, you have to have some little grounding first. So, I said, okay, fine, you come, will you work for my production as a production person? So, I don't know what it is. Then you will go and know. So, Datta also told me, you work with what you have right now. And after this, how you find your way is all up to your skill. Okay. That nobody will help you.
Yeah.
So, to be honest, you have to work hard. That's it.
That is true. You need a break. Plan,
who knows? Yeah. Who knows what will happen? So, I said, okay, fine. It's good enough to start. So, next day, Nandu called me to his office at Taradev, which is a walking distance from Grand Tour. Okay. 20 minutes, you are in Taradev walk. So, I walked up to Taradev, Everest building. He said, come on the second floor. It's something called Triofilms. So, you come there. So, I went to Triofilms. Okay. And to my pleasant surprise, it was Shyam Benegal's office. Shyam Benegal's office where Nandu was operating from. It was a partnership at Ashil Ranjan. Okay. Nandu's father, Govind Bhargav Ghanekar, was a big filmmaker.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And he was trained, Shyam Benegal was trained by Govind Bhargav Ghanekar.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, he was trained by Govind Bhargav Ghanekar. And Girish Ghanekar is Nandu's elder brother. He made many films.
Okay. Radical. I know.
So, these people, yeah. So, I landed up in Shyam Benegal's office. And then Nandu introduced me to Shyam. Basically. And then Shyam also told me, okay, fine, you want to, have you got something? So I showed him the films which I had shot. So he very keenly saw it on his projector. He said, what do you want to learn? I said, I want to learn cinematography. He said, but you know cinematography.
He said it.
Why do you want to learn it?
He said it.
He said, you already know. Yeah, you already know. I said, no, sir. I said, I had seen Ashok Mehta shooting in Goa. And the use of lights and something I don't know. So I have to learn. Yeah, that is minor. He said, what you need to learn is editing. Okay. That is first thing you learn. And would you like to join me as an assistant editor?
He gave you an offer. Yeah. That's great.
Yeah. I said, yeah, I would like to join. He said, okay, he introduced me to Bhanudas Devkar. So he offered me to be an assistant editor to Bhanudas Devkar, who was his editor, who had edited all his films. Okay, and Bhanudas Devkar, 1 year prior to that, had gotten a national award for 36 Chaurangi Lane.
Okay.
Editing 36 Chaurangi Lane.
Mm-hmm,
so I was really in good hands immediately.
Yeah.
And then I asked Nandu. Nandu said, yeah, you continue here then. Doesn't matter. Nandu was very flexible.
Mm-hmm.
He said, like in Kaya Hona Rai ki Mara Javi Lagir Tehve Bolu Na Tula.
Great, great.
I'll come. Okay. Whenever I need a production hand, I'll call you.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, he said, I'm here in this office only, not going anywhere.
This is a great
same
thing.
Office, we have same office. So, we know what we are doing. So, whenever I am need work and I think you can do it, I will call you. That's good enough. Okay. So, then I started working with Bhanudas Devkar, and Bhanudas Devkar happened to be a Goan. So, we were speaking in Konkani most of the time. So I was not very well versed with Hindi. In those days.
Barabar.
Okay. I knew Hindi, obviously, but then I was not so very well versed, and neither was Banu sir. So we both started hit along very well. Then he took me to another guy called Gokte, who was also an editor to Prahlad Khattar.
Mm-hmm.
He was doing ad films. So it was in the same building. So then I used to shuttle from editing stuff like that, then go and sit with Gokte. Okay. Then learn something of ad film editing from Gokte, then again come down. So my this shuttling was going on as far as editing, and I really learned a lot from both these people. Okay. Learn today whatever I can think about filmmaking is only because of Panu sir and Gokte sir. Otherwise I wouldn't have been so good at placing scenes. Exactly. When you know editing, you know what shot to take and what not to take.
Exactly.
Where the shot should end, and economy of images is
something which you can minimize on that.
Absolute economy of images. Otherwise, it's a mess.
Yeah.
Keep on shooting, and you don't know where it's going to cut.
That's
so economy of images is something which I learned. Then, so
you have very little things to edit later on. You have very little things to edit later on.
Exactly. You know what the whole picture is.
Yeah.
How it should look while you're shooting it. Okay. So along the same time, like there was a television serial called Yatra, which was being shot by Shyam Benegal. Okay. So I became a part of Yatra. Okay. And Jahangir Chaudhary was the cinematographer. And there was another young guy called Sanjay Dharankar, also who was doing the outdoor shoot. So it was a travel of a train right from Kanyakumari to Kashmir.
Yeah.
Where we had Rajan Puri, and all those senior actors, you know. And we were all in one, about three bogies that were dedicated to us by Mother of India that time. Uh-huh. And we could attach it to any train in India and go anywhere, wherever we wished. But of course, there was a plan charted out.
Got it.
Just couldn't go that way. But there was a particular plan charted out. Iskewadi. Cities charted out. Things happening. The actors were in the train. So that journey, where I was basically in charge of giving them the stock, that is films, and then taking the exposed films to the lab, giving them to the lab, and then again getting the films wherever they are. So I was flying past and they were in the train, all of them. So my job was to production sort of a thing, you know, to get the films, give it to them. There was a guy called Raj Pius, who was also the main production guy. So he used to handle me. Right from taking the clothes of the actors, giving it for washing, getting them washed, giving it to the actors again, you know, costumes, you know, hang and work, all sorts of work. Okay. And you get to fly with all these sort of things to and fro India, and they were traveling in a train. So that was happening. I should first some days I should sit on the train and again collect things, go. So that was one education which happened, where I knew how production is handled, what is money, how money has to be, you know, counted. Every penny has to be counted, even if it is a big budget thing, you have to count money, basically. So this also was happening at the same time. At the same time, I was editing Yatra also with another director. Okay. Then I edited another film called Sushman for Shyam Babu. Acha karat. Then that one full year went away. Okay. Then I joined through another friend of mine called Sanjeev Shah. He recommended me, who just passed away about a week back. He recommended me to another cinematographer called Sanjay Dharan, where they were doing Ek Kahani, a television serial.
Again, a famous one.
Yeah. Yeah. So Ek Kahani, I landed up in that with Dayal Nehlani, who was Govind's brother, as a director. There I was very happy. I said, okay, now I'm coming to one Nehlani at his close somewhere. He can recommend me. But no, he never did and it never happened. And he was like, I mean, I asked him, so he said, arey, pahle ye to karo. At least learn basic cinematography. So then I started learning with Sanjay, who was very good. Okay. He really taught me well. He taught me in the sense they would not come and teach you something. You have to observe.
That's true.
What is that? Mm-hmm. Okay, you have to observe, you have to work with them, you have to be of any some use to them.
So you have to be receptive.
Basically I was being of use and there was a little understanding which I was developing also. So that was happening. We shot many documentaries with Sanjay. I shot two films with Sanjay called Andhayud with Nana Patekar, Balaji Grover, and Pallavi Joshi. And another film called Karma Yodha with Raj Grover and gang, Dimple Kapadia. So two films I did with him. And by that time, I think I started moving out on my own. I started doing small short films on my own, you know, small producers. So, thank you for the camera. But then I want to do something on my own now. Enough of assistant. Okay. At that point in time, John Roderick's friend, from art college,
uh-huh,
he had come to Bombay. And through me, he got working with Samir Chandra,
mm-hmm,
who was the art director. Okay. Samir Chanda was also doing work for Govind Nalani and everybody. So I was good friends with Samir Da also. Very good friend. And we were like friends, all of us. We were teachers and assistant ashram, but we were more like friends. It was not like, you know, almost of the same age and everybody. So we were all like friends. There was no distinction sort of assistant and everything. All were together. So Samir had asked me to get somebody from Goa College of Art. Where I have worked with him for a while, and he said, "No, I want students from Goa College of Art only. I don't want students from anywhere. I want Goa. I see you work." So I got him John. Okay, John started working with him, and there was one site which was to be done for Govind Nalani. Rukmavati ke avile mane telecereal asat beauty bar. Okay, telecereal. So that I put up the sets with John. So the texture of the sandstone, detailing I used to often go to Rajasthan.
Okay.
I like Rajasthan. So I used to often go to Rajasthan. So I knew the texture. I knew the thing. So as a mold wrestler, Rane Dada. So with Rane Dada, I used to do the moldings. Chitra, Gokhale, Barikte, arches. Of course, there was no reference like what we have today. In those days, it was different. You had to actually go and get photographs and show.
Right.
We went to Rajasthan, clicked pictures of interiors, got them. And so, of course, I had Lal. With aging, weathering, detailing, Sagra. And that is when I met Govinda. Okay. Finally, I wanted to be there. But prior to that, I had worked with them for Tamas.
Okay.
Okay. But as a lightman.
Okay.
Okay. I was in the lighting department because I wanted to do something with Govinda Nalani. Mm-hmm. And that is when I met Murthy Saab there, VK Murthy.
Okay.
Because VK Murthy was his cameraman, was his cinematographer for Tamas, not Govinda Nalani. Govinda Nalani
came to full, it came to full circle. You started VK Murthy, the film that you saw with your father.
And then I was so delighted. I said, okay, eventually I met this man who I started off with. Okay. Then, but there was no chance of talking to him because I was a lightman.
Yeah.
Talking to him, he used to just instruct and go. And not particular, he used to instruct the main light gaffer.
Yeah.
The gaffer used to tell us, okay, you have to do this, you have to do this. Talking to Vikamuthi or talking to Govind Nalani was not on the agenda at all. It was not possible. Because they were far ahead of our reach in those days. So later on, that's where I met. Also, at the same time, we did Bharat Ek Khoj. So, in that Nehru centenary year, Bharat Ek Khoj was being shot, like Visham Banerjee. That again was shot by VK Murthy. So, again, there I was also a lightman. At the same time, I was shooting Ram Lakhan, which was on the next set at Film City with Ashok Mehta. So, I was shuttling between again, like, you know, highlighting curve, then run here, highlighting curve. But I had told, okay, I'll be doing this. And it was okay. I'm sorry, Mukadam Ashilo, he also said, Bharat Ek Khoj, so you do what? Okay, come here on time, that's it. Okay. And then also, Ashok Gaffer also told me the same thing. Can I do no problem. I said, I don't want money. I just want to see. So, I have to earn from here. I have to earn from here. I have to jump around. And I used to do quite so many things. At the end of the day, you are completely packed out. But at the same time, you are completely happy also. Content that, you know, you have put your thing to use. You have understood this and understood that. And that slowly I came to this Rukmavati. That is when I actually had a one-to-one conversation with him. You know, he explained me things. He used to talk to me. He used to talk to my boyfriends. He used to talk to me. And I never imagined, is this a dream or what is it? Because I'm talking to a person who I mean, hold in such a huge...
Adored for
me. So, okay, I'm talking to him. And he explained me one day, because he asked me to light up a scene. And I did conventional lighting, which I knew, which I had learned all the way for about 3-4 years. He said, no, aisa nahi hota hai. I will show you how to do it. And he showed me the actual technique of how to light up a small piece of window and an arch. And that is where it opened all my senses out. That is where all these Rembrandts, the Verniers, the Franz Hals, the Caravaggios came and joined me over there.
It was of use to you.
Yeah, this is what we were saying all the while. So that is how I have picked it up all within a moment. And it has till this day never left me. Till this day, I follow the same thing.
Okay.
Of course, there are permutation combinations of it. I have learned on my own now. Okay. Now, I don't light up the way Govind Nanani lights up anymore. Okay. But it is, the source is the same. The source is the same. Then I learned that Govind Nalani also was an assistant to VK Mukti. Okay. So it was like the same source.
Yeah.
Ashok Mehta also was the assistant to VK Mukti. So the source remained always the same. It didn't change. And then when I checked my photographs, which I took prior to joining films, they were almost the same of what I'm doing today. Okay. It's no different. I'm just mimicking light. Okay, as it is. Okay, if I'm doing daylight, then I'm just mimicking daylight, but there's a huge technique to it. Okay, how to mimic daylight, even if at night, if I'm shooting and I want to create it into a day, I can create it into a day. But for that, you have to have study of that. For that, you have to have study of paintings. You have to have study, understand music. You have to understand rhythm. Okay, you have to understand the shot. You have to understand movement, dynamism. So all this together becomes cinema. It is not just lighting and forgetting. No. It is also all these things. You have to understand the whole rhythm of things. You have to understand the dynamism of the shot. You have to understand that the actor is going to move. So today when I give my exercises to the students, so okay, I tell them, okay, light up Rang Ram Ram. Okay. But then Ram Ram is a painting. Okay. But that character is going to get up and come here.
Yeah.
Or that character is going to move, your space is going to move, you are going to track, or you are going to trolley. Now tell me how Ram Rai is going to light up. Now tell me how, if a character from Ram Rai comes and moves towards the camera and stands and prepares coffee or tea, how will that light be acting on him? It is not just mimicking the light. It is also thinking on your camera. How will you light up now? ये तो first frame तो रमना का था. अभी किसका frame है? अभी तुम्हारा frame है. Now light up. Okay. So that is how I teach even today. I take references from painters, Rembrandt, Franz Hals, Vernier, you know, Caravaggio. So all the painters whom we learned light from. Maybe. You know, even I use abstract painters. Okay. Like Mondrian. You see Mondrian's work, light up now. How to light up? You tell me how to light up. You perceive it. Your own. Because I will not give you ready-made answers. I never got them. I found out on my own. Because if I give you a ready-made answer, you are stuck.
That's
you'll live with the answer for the rest of your life. You'll never explore yourself. I will tell you a situation. And you find the answer. Maybe your answer might surprise me also. I will learn from your answer. But I want you to find out your answer. I will not give you an answer.
You'll be happy also situation. To do that.
Huh?
You'll be happy to know that.
Yeah, and they do explore. Then there is a situation, I tell them I know the answer, but I will not tell you. You have to find out. Because that will be your answer. It is not my answer. That is where you will start exploring yourself. If I give you a ready-made answer, you will be stuck with it for a lifetime. You do the same thing all year, you start imitating me. I don't want you to imitate me. I want you to find yourself. There you
go. Basically, your training in visual art helped you in filmmaking.
Yeah, visual art also and trying to find yourself also. It is very important to find yourself when you are doing cinema or when you are doing anything, even if it is music or whatever it is. It is very important that you explore yourself.
That's true.
Your personality has to be there in what you do. Okay, your study, your atma as well.
Sir.
If you have ready-made card, it is like giving you a box of things. It might help you to gain a few people. That's. But will you be exploring yourself? You will do the same three-point lighting for your whole life and learn nothing out of it. But But for that, you have control over that. I always say boredom is a very nice thing. You know, when you're bored, you start, that means something new is happening.
Yeah.
You are bored with what is there. Now something new is happening. So concentrate on boredom. It is always good. It makes you look at a different perspective altogether.
That is.
Yeah.
Okay, Shirish Bab, tell me something about your experience with V.K. Murthy Saab, whom you are very closely associated with. In fact, I think you are one of his favorite individuals with cinematography background.
Murthy Saab, basically we used to call him Murthy Saab. Everybody used to call him that. Okay. He and I, basically, I don't know whether we are destined or what. Okay. So I wish I had a picture of it. So what had happened was when I was in school, in college, we had gone to Rajasthan. Okay. And there was this shooting of a film called Rajput, which was happening there with Vinod Khanna, Rajesh Khanna, Hema Malini. Okay. And I found Hema Malini sitting on one rock. So I requested her that I could take a picture of her. So she said yes. And there was somebody standing behind her waving hands like this. So I wanted that person to go away. So waited for some time. I just wanted her. But I didn't have a lens which was to crop her or something like that. But yeah, black and white good picture. So waited, and then I asked her, is this man going to go from there? So she laughed. She said, no, he's not going to go from there. So I said, okay. And that's the picture, click current. And I have the picture with me even today. So that picture remained. And later on, when I came to Bombay, I came to know that it was V.K. Murthy standing behind. I still have the picture of it. So it was him who was standing behind and waving at the reflector, which I didn't realize that. So that is the sort of an association, I would say, which we had subconsciously, unconsciously, whatever.
Everything is very linked, as I say.
Yeah, it was linked in it. So I showed that picture to Murthy Saab later on, and he laughed. I was waiting for you to move away from here. So yeah, okay. So what happened was that I met him. Basically, I was shifting my house. Prior to that, I had worked with him for, as I told you, Tamas and Shahadat Expose, but he didn't know me. I was there around. But one day then, I was shifting my house in Bandra. I was going to stay in Bandra, and there was a friend of mine called Vinay Magadi, who was my roommate there. It was like 4 or 5 people of us used to stay in one apartment. So there was Vinay, Nitin Ramani, there was Arvind Sahai, and then there was a guy called Ajit Rana, who was a grandson of Maharani Gayatri Devi. So we were all staying there in that particular apartment. Okay. So I met Vinay. So Vinay, on the first day, he asked me, what do you do? And all that. So he said, Nitin told me that a great cameraman is coming. I said, no, I'm not great. So yeah, he said, what do you do? I said, cinematography. Yeah. So even my grandfather is a cinematographer. So yeah, okay. I said, what's his name? V.K. Murthy. He's your grandfather. Yeah, he's my grandfather. I said, he's your grandfather. I said, yeah. So I said, I want to work with him. He said, okay, I'll call him. So he immediately called him, Tata, there's a friend of mine who wants to work with you. I said, okay, send him. So I landed up in Natra Studio at Pramod Chakravarti's office. They were doing this film called Didar, which was Akshay Kumar's first film.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So they were undergoing that shoot. Already, I think so, one schedule was over, and I joined them. So he called me, he talked to me, and he said, okay, join from tomorrow. Okay. Then there was a guy called Prabhakar, KG Prabhakar, who was in charge. So KG took me on, and KG was a wonderful person. So he like took an instant liking for me. He said, okay, chalo, I'll say shuru kar. So next day, like I was shooting, and that is how I started shooting with V.K. Murthy. And then as time went on, You know, there were many things which kept on happening. You know, he saw how I was working, basically, and he really took up a liking for me. Then he started training me on small things. You know, he used to tell me small things, which seemingly were he wouldn't tell anybody. But the next film when we signed together, I told him, I said, I need the whole script first. I will read the script and then I'll decide whether I should do this film or not. So he was pretty surprised. He said, what do you mean you have a choice? I said, yeah, I would want to know whether I really want to do the film or what, basically. Because I said, I didn't enjoy the previous film so much. Of course, I'm working with you and I enjoy that. But I want to enjoy the film also. He liked that idea.
Attitude.
He said, yeah, that's very good to be honest. He tell me that, you know, okay, let me have a choice. He said, okay, I'll give you the script. He gave me the script. I didn't like it initially. But then we sat together, he explained me the whole script. Like, this is how it is. And then I started our association with working. So, and you have to do this films also. Don't say that, okay, I don't want to do this. No. You have to learn this also. How to adjust, how to stretch, how to, you know, circumcise yourself. Yes, sab sikhna hai. You should be able to do every second film. And he did change my concepts of filmmaking to a large extent. Every film is a good film. It depends on how you see it. Okay. Don't say that commercial films are stupid. They're not stupid. Okay. And that's when, like, I started learning with him. You know, I was doing television for the first time. Television camera. I mean, like, he used to always do, but television camera he was doing for the first time. So he said, he called me. Just imagine, he started from in the 40s, in the 30s, with hand-trained camera, when he was arriving to a digital age, where he was still, the yearning for learning was always there. He wanted to learn new things. He wanted to learn everything. I mean, I can just imagine how much must have changed from his time to here, exactly. The lights. But yet that thirst for learning was never gone from him. So he called me, I went there, I lit up. He told me, okay, light up the way you feel is right. So I did light up because he never interfered in my writing. Nothing. He just allowed me to do. After I finished, he called me and he said that, okay, fine, you're done. So I said, yeah. He said, this is it. He said, okay, how do you, this is the ready made. I said, yeah. So how do you judge? You have a monitor and look at the monitor, it's ready made. He said, yeah, but if the monitor changes, if it's a different monitor, how will you, which image will be right? That monitor or this monitor? Every monitor is different. Then every house will have a different monitor. So how do you decide which is the right image? On the film, we have parameters. Okay, fine. You take a meter and you have a parameter. Where is the parameter here? So actually, I started thinking that I had never thought about it. What is the parameter? He said, no, get your meter. I said, okay, but the meter does not match with the camera because our ISOs are different, the camera's gains are different. So he said, no, that light hai. I said, yeah. Lens hai. Yeah.
Wow.
Image hai. So we will have to do something and figure it out. There must be some match somewhere. So I said, sir, there is actually no match between the meter reading and between the camera because the ISOs and gains are entirely different. It's a different palette altogether. So you just do what I'm telling you. Let us see. Even I'm learning with you, even I don't know. Maybe we'll strike up something.
Wow.
So, okay, let's try and do it. So he got a gray card, a big one, put it in front of the camera. He said, okay, take a lamp, take a light, slap it on it. Slapped it on it. Okay, your flag correction, everything is fine. Yeah. Okay, set the exposure on auto for the camera. Set it on off. Kitna rikara hai? 5.6. You cannot take a meter and exactly read what the light is. Red, it's 11. So what is your ISO? It's 200 AC. It's okay. Keep on turning it until it matches, the meter matches 5.6. So I kept on turning it. He said, yeah, I said at 400, 450 AC, it comes to 5.6. He said, okay, that means this is 5.6, this is 5.6. Now it is 450 AC. Now light according to 450 AC. and you get everything. You shut the monitor off. You don't need the monitor now.
Wow.
So I shut off the monitor and we lit up exactly according to the 450 ASA parameters with the meter. And when I switched on the camera, it was better image than what it was.
Oh.
So here I was going to teach him and I hit me the whole new and after that I have never ever in my life lit up, even if it's an interview, I never lit up without a meter.
Okay.
Because you must write, you don't know the parameters.
Hmm.
Every time a camera changes, every time the camera changes, a little difference is there. So you have to find out the difference. Then he went to further details to tell me ki, you also have to know from which place this television is telecast, whether it's from Korea, whether it's from India, what is the angle, which is the satellite which is picking up the signal, which is the satellite which is transmitting.
Hmm.
Because tevda loss asko.
Okay.
That much loss is there. So you have to calculate the angle of projection and you have to calculate the angle of projection from the satellite and then calculate your exposures here while you are shooting. So you can imagine how much of a study he did and he gave it to me within a minute. So this was a sort of a learning which we got from him. You just don't depend on what you see. You have to think, you have to study.
That's true. Experience count.
So that was what Mr. Experience and also being innovative.
Innovative, yeah.
You know, you have to be the saksharkar zalda log asta pa.
Jana.
Experience of every gosht as an saksharkar regular.
Got it.
Saksharkar as an experience is tight sambandh.
Right.
Nyaneshwara experience na chilo saksharkar na
chilo. Barabar. Sarakhi.
So that is the way it is. I mean,
new
technology and he adapted to it just like that. That was the lesson, not that what he taught me. The lesson was to remain agile and to remain alive. till the your breath, your last breath. So he had told me a very beautiful thing in which I agree with till today. He said, I am always scared when I come to the studio to light. The day I don't feel scared, I will stop cinematography.
Ah, wow.
So you have to feel scared. Because when you are scared, you are alive.
That's true. But
if you are not scared, if you think you know it, you are working from experience and you are doing, you are repeating the same thing, you are not doing anything. It's the same thing with artists. The moment you see a blank canvas,
right,
you have to be very scared. If you are assured, that means you are only working from your experience. You are working from your
mechanical.
You are not doing anything new.
Yeah.
When you are doing something new, you are scared.
You're not
when you're doing something you don't know. Yeah, you have to come from where you don't know. So I asked President Mutizar, you have so much of work, about 50 years of work, and you still say you're scared. He said, yeah, I have butterflies in my stomach. If there's no butterflies in my stomach, he said, I can't work. I will go home. So you have to be alive, you have to be scared, you have to that. Feeling of I don't know has to be there constantly, even after you have taken the shot. If you think that there is a mistake which has happened, he said, don't correct the mistake there. Correct it in the next shot. Correct it in the next film. There has to be something. And next time you take up a film, you have to say, you have to feel, you know, I have made some mistakes. Now I'm not going to make. You can make new mistakes, but don't repeat the mistake. Ever. Make new mistakes. Doesn't matter.
Yeah. You learn something new.
Don't make the same mistake. Learn from the mistake. Make new mistakes.
Right.
You have to make mistakes. That is only what keeps you alive.
That is right.
Yeah.